Scott, don't forget you can check out CalebOnTheBand.com for a very special way to ring in the new year with our friend Tim.
Hello there. Is that recording? Yes, it is. These are worship flags. I get them on Call the Flag. I love them. So awesome. My sewing machine broke on me, so I get them there. That's cool. Oh, especially these. These ones, these are spoon flags, and they have a butterfly on them. And I really like them. So beautiful. And look, it even has the edge, the rippled edge on the edge. You see? Totally butterfly shape. I love them. I think of Romans 12:2. It says, do not be conformed to the pattern of this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. Hallelujah, huh? We're transformed by the renewing of our mind. You know why you have to be reading your Bible? Because you need to be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Because Satan is the lowercase g god of this world. Yes, yes, he is. He is real. And there's a spiritual warfare going on in your mind. Right now, the devil is using COVID and a spirit of fear and death to put fear in people. But the Bible says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God to the pulling down of strongholds. So you gotta read your word, because it's like a sword to slice the weapons that the devil's using against us, which are spiritual. They're not carnal. The weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God to the pulling down of strongholds. You gotta use the sword of God to cut the lies of the enemy. COVID is real. People are dying from it. But God told us not to fear death. We're not supposed to fear death as Christians. We are not supposed to live our life here. We should be ready to die, however it may be, while we're doing the work of God and not living under the bondage of fear. We're called to put our hands on the sick and cast out devils and heal the lepers. Heal the sick. God gave us in Matthew chapter 10, verse 1, it says that he gave the disciples power to heal all manner of diseases. Go check it out. Matthew chapter 10, verse 1. He gave the disciples power to heal all manner of diseases. Last night I was reading the Bible, and I did not see that part in that scripture before, but God showed it to me last night. We're not supposed to run away from COVID. We're not supposed to be scared of COVID. We're not supposed to be scared of death. We should be ready to die for Christ at any time. And if dying for Christ includes getting COVID because you were ministering to somebody or serving somebody that was sick and needed help, then good. You're going to die doing what God calls us to do. And pray for them, their sickness to be healed. Don't be scared of it. Put your hands on the sick and cast out devils. Like, heal the sick. He has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. Don't be scared of COVID. Don't be scared of death. You know, we do get sick sometimes. Even though the disciples had the ability to heal all manner of sickness, sometimes God, he can heal us, but he doesn't always heal. So if you do get COVID, know that God will be with you in it. He'll get you through every second of it. And when it's too much for us, he's given our body such thing as called sleep, so you can rest. Sometimes when I'm feeling a lot of pain in my body, especially pressure in my head, I felt like I can't do it anymore. And then all of a sudden I fall asleep. And I see it's God's grace. It says in the Bible, his grace is sufficient for us. In our weakness, his strength is made perfect. And it truly is. I find that in my most desperate times of physical affliction, God's strength comes through me, and or I'll fall asleep. He'll give me strength or I'll fall asleep. He's good. He never gives us more than we can bear. He's always with us in it. He's in the fire with us like he was for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. We weren't given a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. The weapon is fear, the cure is faith. The weapon is fear, the weapon is fear. Satan is the lowercase g, god of this world. Remember his weapons. Oh, he's like literally waging war against people's minds right now. And people are dying from COVID, but don't be scared of getting COVID. But you know what I do? I stand on the word. I don't believe I'll get COVID. Psalms 91 says, the truth is our shield and buckler. No plague will come nigh our dwelling. Go check it out. It's in there. I may not be quoting it exactly right, but it's in Psalms 91. It says that his truth is a shield and a buckler. So I take that truth, which says no plague will come nigh my dwelling, because I abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I abide under his shadow. And it says no plague will come nigh my dwelling. And it says, his truth is my shield and buckler. So I take his truth and I put my faith in him. Faith is the key to releasing from the fear of COVID. Put your faith in the Lord. He can protect you from the plague. In the Old Testament, if I remember right, I'm pretty sure I do. He protected, remember with Pharaoh? God sent plagues because Pharaoh wouldn't listen. This world don't listen. They don't want to come to you. They want to do evil. But if you remember, they had plagues. But God's people, they didn't have plagues. God protected them. He's the same God today, yesterday, and tomorrow. Put your faith in the Lord. Here is the weapon being used against us. Faith in the Lord is the key to your freedom. Faith in the Lord is your key to your freedom from fear. Put your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Turn from your wicked ways. And times of refreshing will come. Times of refreshing, hallelujah. You need times of refreshing in your soul. This world will beat you down. Satan is real. He'll beat you down. God came to restore. Jesus is the truth, the life, and the way. And this world is death. Spiritual death, physical death. But Jesus came to give his life. Life more abundantly in the spirit, not in the flesh. It's not about earthly riches. They don't make you happy. Love not this world, neither the things that are in this world. They're all passing away. Jesus is going to come and burn this place up, and there's going to be a new heaven and a new earth. No more sin. And those who want to love God and follow in his light by obeying him will be with him in eternity. Obeying him is easy. Simply love people, forgive people, and put your faith in Christ. Don't hold unforgiveness and bitterness. Don't walk in fear, walk in faith with God. Put your faith in the Lord. He died for you. He's the only one perfect. You're not a good person. We all fall short of the glory of God. We have all sinned against God. But Jesus died to reconcile us to God. Jesus did. He's the truth and life and the way. And no one comes to the Father except through him. You gotta repent for your sins. Turn from them. Turn from your sins because they bring forth death. And you'll be eternally separated from God. And you don't want that. You don't want to go to hell. It's a horrible place. And God doesn't wish any perish. But he'll come to repentance. But some people, you want to be so prideful. You want to be wise in your own eyes. You want to continue in your wicked ways. I don't get that. You need to fear God and depart from evil. It'll be health to your bones and marriage. Health to you. It'll be health to you and your spirit. God will bring refreshing and healing to your soul that you can't get through money, but only through him. He loves you very much. He died for your sins. Don't mock him. Love him. Accept him in your heart. Receive the gift of forgiveness for your sins so you could be reconciled to God. You need God. You can't do it on your own. It's too hard. You're foolish if you want to follow your own way and you don't want God. You think you have strength? God will show you different. You don't. You need God. Accept Jesus' forgiveness for your sins. Read the Bible. Get to know the Lord. Pray to him. He's real. He's waiting to hear from you. He is real. He is spirit and truth. Those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth. Read his word. It's living water. It's transforming. It will change you like a butterfly is transformed. This world is evil. Satan is lowercase g god of this world. Listen, it's a fallen world. Sin separates us from God in our soul, which is your mind, your will, and emotion. Jesus made a way so you could be connected with God. So don't spit on Jesus or mock Jesus, but accept his merciful forgiveness for your sins. And you will feel his love. His love is so precious, so amazing, and it can't be bought, and no human will fill you like his love will. You have a hole in your heart, and you have pain inside of you. And God wants to heal that. Jesus wants to heal that pain in you. No human can do it. No therapist can do it. Only the Holy Spirit can do it. And he uses people to help facilitate that. But you need to lean on him as your source of strength and not people. And if you read your word, if you pray to him in sincerity, if you come into repentance, and you obey his word, like don't pay evil for evil, like forgive people, like don't hold a grudge against others, like his word will show you how wicked you really are. It'll convict you if you'll receive his conviction. His word is spirit and truth. So when you read it, you're reading him. It's truth. Come to repentance. Come to know him. He loves you. Don't trash his love. You need it. You need his strength. He's a deliverer. He's a refuge. He's a fortress. He's a comforter, better than people. He's living water. His word is living water. Give you life in your soul, your spirit,
Sin has separated us from God, but Jesus took the penalty for our sin so we could be reconciled from God. And it'll teach you the ways of righteousness and holiness, and you gotta turn from that sin that you love so much. You gotta turn from it, because it's bringing death to your soul. And God wants to give you life, like joy and peace. And he'll give you self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Those are the fruits of the Spirit, which you can't walk in your own strength. You need the power of the Holy Spirit to help you. Give you joy and a peace that surpasses all understanding. It's a free gift. Jesus died so you could be reconciled to God. Accept his forgiveness for your sins, and he'll help you walk out of those chains of sin in your life. He will. And you'll feel happy. And you'll shine, because he'll put his light in you. And you'll be the salt of the earth and the light for his glory. Not yours, but his. Bye-bye.